What's up, YouTube? It's your boy, Tony Mac, man, with another interview with one of the up-and-coming comedians out of the DFW, my homeboy, Mosh Pit. Mosh Pit, say what's up to the people and introduce yourself.
What's good? Mosh Pit. Real name, Adrian Vasquez. Yeah.
Man, you ain't about to get yourself arrested, y'all. Omit that, what he just said, man. Anyway, man, my boy, Mosh Pit, funny comedian, man, music enthusiast, wrestler when he want to sometime, and also sometime cowboy fan. So Mosh Pit, bro, I want to know, man, what made you get into comedy, bro?
Just basically being an audience member, just coming out to Manhattan every Monday night.
Word.
Then I finally decided to do it, and been doing it ever since.
Jordan Mack, shout out to Mad Hatters. Man, so Mad Hatters, that was the first spot you did open mic at?
Yeah.
Word. Bro, most people be starting out like improv and hyenas, man. How was it going up there the first time at Mad Hatters, bro?
The first time was, I believe, 2019-20. And long story short, I was in a manic episode, bipolar, and the host.
Perfect
at the
recipe
time,
to be a great comedian. Bipolar. It's all that. That's how you make it, baby. Got to be crazy.
The host at the time and basically the creator of Mad Hatter open mics, Zach Rippey. I showed up.
Well,
as soon as they were about to wrap up, and he's like, "You get up there." I didn't even sign up, no nothing.
And, word.
Just did my thing. I'm pretty sure it was a bunch of hoopla, but everybody loved it. Got three free Lone Star beers because I was like,
a little nervous.
No, I actually said during my set, I was like, "Came to my favorite bar. Don't have any money though. If you want to buy me a Lone Star." More than welcome to.
Shout out.
Got three motherfucking beers.
Three beers, baby. That mean your set went well that first night, man. That's awesome, man. And all my people suffering from BP disorder, I'm just joking, man. That's just us comedians talk. We like to call ourselves crazy so we can feel better. I don't think nobody's crazy. Anyway, so we got the Cowboys this week, man. Us 49ers, and I see you rocking the throwback jacket over there looking like the Mexican Jimmy Johnson about to lead your boys to victory, man. Y'all think y'all gonna do it this year? How you feeling?
Every year, we're gonna do it.
Every year, y'all year?
Every year is our year. It's just something that always fucking happens.
Word.
But to basically speak on that, there was a friend on Twitter that tweeted today, and he said 49ers and the Cowboys is like a Mexican Super Bowl. Yes. Both teams, yeah.
I'm cool with it. I'm cool with it. As long as the 49ers win the Super Bowl, I'm cool with it. Because the old Mexican 49ers Super Bowl, it was us and the Raiders. Yeah. I used to watch them fights on YouTube. They used to tear it down, boy.
Also seen something that was like, Mexicans only love the Raiders, the 49ers, and the Cowboys.
Straight up. All those teams, they ride with them, bro. And as big a fan as I am, you are not about to outfan my Mexican community, bro. Because you might love your team, but you not about to paint your entire car the color of your team. You not about to do it like they are. I'm telling you, they're going to represent,
hell
baby.
Nah.
They are going to represent, man. Speaking of represent, what you think of Jamal, which one was it? And Canelo. Was it Jamal? Yeah, Jamal Charlo.
I pronounce it Charlo.
Charlo, yeah.
Charlo.
Shout out to Jamal and Canelo, man. I know y'all was getting that money. Y'all had to get that bag up.
I actually seen the last few rounds of that fight, so I can't speak too much on it. But,
you know you was celebrating, nigga.
I was celebrating.
You know y'all was celebrating. Yes!
Rounds, and, Canelo.
Y'all was getting y'all get back for all the Mayweathers.
Canelo's the second coming of Jesus. That's all I
gotta say. He's the second coming of Jesus.
Yeah.
Canelo, the closest thing to Jesus. Nah, man. Canelo look like he on his way to get up out of that, though, bro. Like, he look good, but I just feel like his energy, like, he feel like, man, fuck, it's only so much hundreds of millions I need, you know? Canelo, no matter how much shit you accomplish, you still got your ass whooped by Floyd Mayweather Jr. And we're going to hold that up every Cinco de Mayo. Now I'm playing.
I'm
talking trash.
Charlo, he didn't have anything from the gate after
at all, bro.
After he had basically the cartel, like the people that.
Well, they told him you go lay down. Yeah.
Santa Fe Clan. Yeah. Basically, that's like narco rap right there.
Yeah, they say, yeah, you gonna lay down this fight, buddy. Yeah. See, man, you gonna get my channel taken down by the cartel. They gonna say the same thing to YouTube. My channel gonna be gone because of you. Nah, man, I think Charlo shouldn't have put up that much weight, bro. Maybe like his brother, if he didn't have a mental disorder, I think the other twin might have gave Canelo some smoke. But I just think Jamel being and walking around at 154, that might have been a little too much.
One thing I want to talk about about boxing is seeing Terrence Crawford basically downing Charlo. He's like, dude, you're not on my hit list anymore. You know what I mean?
Like,
you laid down for Canelo and you ain't shit now.
You got beat up for a bag. That's what he told him. Say what exactly he said. You got beat up for a bag. But nah, I mean, I do like the fact that Charlo, right after the fight, wasn't even like, he took it like a man. He took his L. Like, look, I lost, whatever, whoop, whoop. I wasn't afraid. I went up there, I did it. But everybody know I want Terrence Crawford. I don't think you're going to get Terrence Crawford now, bro. I think Terrence Crawford.
After that, like,
I think Terrence Crawford about to beat Errol Spence in that rematch, like the 49ers about to beat the Cowboys in the rematch and send his ass back to Dallas. Like, we're going to send their ass back to Dallas. I think that's what's about to happen, G. Shout out to Errol Spence, my nigga. You a champion is measured by his wins, not his losses. You still a champ, Errol Spence. But if Terrence Crawford is walking down the street, you call the cops. That's all I'm going to tell your ass, nigga. You call the cops, get your ass up out of there. Leave that nigga alone. Anybody with hair like that, is tough. His hair tough, he tough. Leave him alone. Leave him alone. Anyway, man. So, Mops Pit, you've been in the game 3 years, bro. 3 years, man. So, how's it going for you? Like, what was the highlight of this shit?
Well, I had my first showcase. Shout out to Ian Mack.
Word, shout out to Ian Mack.
Sunday best. Actually, this upcoming Sunday, I'm on my second showcase, so it's finally paying off.
Oh, shit.
Just been trying to perfect my craft, come up with good material at every single mic that I hit. Just recently this year, I've been going to constant mics throughout the week just to...
Just step your game up. Ain't nothing wrong with that. Got it. This the grind, y'all, man. When we start out doing this shit, all them comedians y'all see on TV, all them on Wildin' Out and all that stuff, this how it start. It's the grind. It's the open mics. Week after week after week, shit, day after day. Some people hitting 4 mics a day in comedy to make it. So, you know, how bad you want it, man. And I respect those who still get up there and hit the mics. Some of these motherfucking world name comedians might want to go back to these open mics and start touching up some shit, you ask me. But that's just me telling my truth, y'all. So, but you was in the wrestling too, man. How did that go?
I'm still in the wrestling, though.
Oh, still in the wrestling.
It's just,
WWE kicked that nigga out, y'all, so we got to move on to the next question. He got kicked out of WWE.
He let me go last week with all the fire.
They caught him wearing all that Roman Reigns gear. They say his ass got to go. He out there trying to tell these women out here in Fort Worth he Roman Reigns and shit. They got kicked out of WWE, so we can't talk about that, y'all. We got to move forward.
Just clear the room here. Clear the air. We're outside. But,
like New Japan or Ring of Honor?
Ring of Honor, AEW, the guy that owns that, or CEO, you know, being funded by his daddy, you know, Tony Khan, bought Ring of Honor. Haven't kept up with that, but more like GCW, which is
okay.
They're a big name independent promotion right now, from basically New Jersey, you know, but they run all throughout the United States. Actually, both. They've hit Japan, Australia, England, and this is all funded by the fans. Right. Really.
Now, see, I got a partner that do the wrestling too, man. Shout out to Bad Business, man. But he does the wrestling, and he say the same thing as you, is that they like, man, WWE, No hate is cool, but y'all don't be fucking, y'all don't be trying to fuck with it. Why is it like that, man?
It's just horrible.
Even
right?
though I be trying to convince him, like, nigga, Vince McMahon knock on your door, you better sign that motherfucking contract. You out here tripping. Well, it ain't gonna be Vince McMahon. It might be somebody else. It ain't, it may not be Vince McMahon. He is some shit, but allegedly.
Just to speak on that, is WWE isn't what it used to be because horrible writers, and they do not put good talent in good positions to make it. They've had a lot of good names, mm-hmm. and they've done nothing with them. So they had to go elsewhere to get them back.
They do got this dude, LA Knight, or something like that. Yes. What you think of him?
I haven't been really keeping up with it, like I said, but I've seen his promos throughout social media. He is a motherfucking G.
I like his shit. He remind me Stone Cold to rock with it. I like his shit.
I wouldn't say that.
He ain't on their level, but he remind me of that. When they used to cut them promos, it give you a little of that.
Great mic skills. He got that work. For those that don't know, LA Knight, you, about 4 or 5 years ago, was a part of Impact, formerly known as TNA, and he was making shit over there with the promos. He made a name for himself.
Yeah.
Eli Drake. He does the same shit. LA Knight. You know what I mean?
Bro, I didn't ever even catch that. Damn, you put me on game to that.
Yeah.
Word, man.
He's a G. Like, people talk down on him because he was a never has been. He was a never was. He's barely getting his shun now, and he's already, late 30s, early 40s.
Yeah, I think early 40s.
He's getting 40s. His bag now. So
but he's been in the game like, 25 years?
Yes.
He put in work. Yeah.
Deserves it.
That's how it go, man. Like, a lot of time we see on television, y'all, that it looks like you'll see somebody pop out of nowhere, and it's like, oh, they only been doing it for maybe 6 months or a year, man. But some of this shit take years. Years, a lot of talent, hard work, and some good-ass luck. Yeah. Being in the right place at the right time with the right mind.
Exactly.
You know? So, man, you want to leave the people with something dope to say, some advice or anything, man?
Basically, I think I mentioned that I'm bipolar. So, all I want to say is just keep riding it to the wheels full of whatever you're going through. You know, have a good support system. Talk to your family, your friends, and never, never look down on yourself. Past experiences, the shit you done wrong, you're always going straight ahead, never zigzag the shit.
That's real.
You just gotta keep on going.
That's real, man. And anywhere they can find you, man, any social media handles you want to put out there?
Basically on Instagram, I don't know if people are still on Twitter. I'm not gonna fucking call it X, Elon Musk, fuck you. But,
Elon, we're not trying to fuck you. We got to.
Handle is King of the Funk.
King of the Funk.
Yes, 817 on Instagram. I believe on Twitter, it's King of the Funk 81G. That's 817 for people that don't know.
Right on.
And if people are still on the Facebook, Adrian Vasquez. So.
Very simple. He got a boxer's last name, Vasquez. That made him be a champ, y'all. Yes. Man, anyway, y'all, this is Tony Mack. Thank y'all for tuning in. Appreciate y'all getting to know my man, Mos Pit, bro. Very dope individual, funny, talented guy. Y'all know me, man. We don't practice no hate, all love, all real. Tony Mack. Peace. Y'all saw the rug I was going to use to wipe my feet off on?